Hey guys, what's up and welcome. Thank you so much for clicking this video. We are continuing with our to-do application, an advanced one. In case you are new, this started here. This is part one, part two, part three, four, and five. And now we are on part six. Let me show you what we are going to do in part six. Number one, when you log in here, this application will let you know via email that you have logged in. As you know that most application, they do so. Maybe if you are logging in from a different place, which is unusual, or maybe there are many attempts to your logging in into your application. Most big application, big platform like Spotify, they notify you via email. So I am going to teach you the email sending part. So let's log in here. First of all, let me show you that I don't have an email from the to-do app. Okay, as you can see, guys, I don't have an email. But as soon as I log in here with this username and click log in, then I'm supposed to get an email being notified that I have logged in. Let's go and check that and also check the timestamp as well. So let's just go back here and let's just wait or refresh. Suppose we get an email. As you can see, guys, here is it from the to-do app. Let's click and read it. New login, it's September, the date and the timestamp. Your email, which is this email, has just logged in. Okay, so let's just delete this one. Okay, let's just maybe delete this one. Okay, and let's log out and log in again just to be sure. Okay, so that you can be sure that this is working, as you can see, guys. So let's log in again. Okay, let's go back to the emails. Let's just wait a bit. We are going to receive an email from the application, as you can see, guys. Okay, obviously it costs to have an application that sends an email. Maybe you need to subscribe or register to a certain email API or provider. Luckily for you, we've got a free API that you can use. The only thing that you can do is to supply an application name and the username. I'm going to show you in this tutorial, and the link to this API, it's in the description, so you can just click and come here. What you are going to do here, you are going to give me your app name and you are going to put your email address. Once you are done, you this will send an API key to your email, and that will be it. And then from then you can come here and click on the documentation. As you can see, guys, this is the documentation. Okay, so I'm going to teach you how to integrate this easy, fast and simple email sender, as you can see, guys. And then this tutorial doesn't end there, guys. We are going to create this dashboard. Okay, as you can see here, let me show you guys. Also, you can create a task. Okay, let's say, what is the task? Let's say our task is send email. Okay, the task is send email. Maybe we can go back and confirm on the stats. Okay, as you can see, guys, we've got one pending task, one in progress, one completed and one cancelled. Okay, so now we are going to add another task, which is a pending task. Okay, so I'm expecting here on my stats to have two pending tasks. So let's just jump straight into it. Send email. Okay, and then we are going to check a date, and then we are going to put an image there, and then just testing. Okay, just testing, as you can see, guys. So let's save this task, which is send email. Okay, as you can see, guys, the task has been saved. Let's go back to our dashboard and see how many pending tasks do we have. As you can see, guys, it immediately updates because we've got two pending tasks. What is the stack of this build? We are using Next.js, we are using React.js, we are using TypeScript, and we are using Tailwind. I forgot to mention, we are using 10-stack query as well. So, and also Prisma, guys. So we've got a MySQL database that is installed, or that is sitting on XAMPP. And as you can see, guys, these are our tasks. Let's refresh. So we are saving into the database. We are using Prisma to do that. So I'm going to teach you all of that here. Without wasting time, guys, let's just jump straight into it. In case you might want to support me, please come and check at Udemy, search Matthew Msingati. I've got these two courses here. In case also you want to learn Figma, I've got also a free course here on Udemy. Just search my profile, Matthew Msingati. You will see under my profile, there will be also a free course here. But in case you've got some small budget, you want to learn and become a better developer, please come and support me, guys. Here, I've got this course and I've got this one. The first one and the second one are my courses. Thank you so much. Let's just jump straight into it. Hey guys, what's up and welcome. It's Matthew here, the designer and developer from South Africa. Let's continue with our to-do application, advanced to-do application. So what we can do now, we can log in or we can register. And at the same time, once we register, we can get into the dashboard. So let me just show you. We've got demo. So once we are logged in, as you can see, we can get into the dashboard. Okay, so what are we going to do in this tutorial? In this tutorial, I want us to implement the emailing part of the dashboard. Do you notice that in most applications like Spotify, maybe Google, whenever there is something suspicious happening in your own account, they will send you an email. Maybe you have logged in with a new device, or maybe you are logging in from a location that is unusual to Google. Let's say you are staying in a different province, and then now you visited a different province. So when you log in there, it will tell you that you have logged in from a suspicious or from a different location. So obviously they do that via email. So what I'm trying to communicate here, or what I'm trying to say, is email integration in your application, I think it's important. Okay, you can't avoid it. Okay, so now what we want to do here, we want to notify the user every time when they log in. We want to some sort of tell them that they have logged in. Okay, and obviously you can customize this and make it better and make it meaningful, but what I'm going to show you is just the technique, and then you can go ahead and say whatever you want to say to the user. Okay, so let's just log out. Okay, let's just log out, and then we need to first register with the email that I am going to use. So what do I mean? I mean the real email, okay, not demo@gmail, because these emails don't exist. So we need to first register here with a some sort of a real life email. Okay, so apologies about that. Let's see, I want this email. Okay, this is the email that I want. This is the email that I want. So let's register a user with this email, because we are going to use this email. Okay, so what's the username? Let's say Matthew. Okay, coded, let's say Matthew from Coded Design. And my password, let's say 12345. Okay, 12345, and let's upload an image. Let's see, let's upload an image. Okay, let's say this is my image, and let's register. Okay, let's register Matthew Coded, and we've got a real life email there. Okay, let me save this. Okay, so as you can see, guys, here is my profile. I can log in and log out. So let me just log out for now so that I can test the logging in. Okay, let's test if I can log in. So as soon as I log in, then we need to get into the emailing functionality. So what are we going to use in order to email, to send emails? Okay, we are going to use this API. This is Coded Mail. Okay, this API can help you to send emails. Okay, so how does it work? You give it the application name and also your email, and then it will send an API key to your email, and then you will use that API key to send emails. Very simple, and it's for free. Okay, that's what I like about it, it's for free. So let's continue, guys, and see what we can do. I hope I am not registered here. Okay, to do app. Okay, so what will happen is if I'm already registered, they will send an API key to me because I'm already registered. Okay, they will send my API key instead. So it's either here, I'm going to get a new API key, like a message that tells me I've got an API key, or it will tell me that I've already registered, here's my API key. So you can come here and give it the name of your app, and then from then and type your email. Okay, so is here is my email, and then the link to this API will be in the description. Okay, so feel free to come here and register, it's for free. Okay, so let's register, guys, and see what will happen. Let's register and see, because now I don't know if I created an account before or I didn't, so I just have to see. Okay, as you can see, API key sent successfully, so it looks like I was not registered. Okay, so let's check this email to see if we are going to get, as you can see, guys, here is the email from Coded Mail, and it gives us the API key. So for now, let's keep this like this for now. Let's keep this like this, and then let's go back here and let's go to the documentation. Okay, so let's get into the documentation. So as you can see, here is the documentation. Okay, Coded Mail, it's a simple email sender for small projects. Okay, so we already got the API key. So what you need to do, guys, here, you need to make sure that you install Axios. Okay, NPMI Axios, make sure that you've got the Axios, because this, in fact, any request, okay, it's either you use a fetch or you use an Axios, but this example specifically, it uses Axios. Okay, okay, so what you need to do here, you need to open a folder, helpers, and a helper.ts. okay, and then we are going to copy this code as it is, and that is it. Okay, so if you look at this code, there is an email object here. Okay, this is the email that you are sending to, this is the header of your message, this is the subject, this is the API key, the one that we got via email, and this is the body of the message, and that is it. And then the other things you don't really need to know much about. Okay, I don't want to confuse you. Okay, so what we are going to do, we are going to copy this, and we are going to go to our folder, which is helpers. Do we have a folder helpers here? Let's see, we've got a helper helpers, and we all already got helper.ts. so what I'm going to do, I'm just going to delete this one. Okay, maybe I was testing this package for something else. So obviously this is not found. Let me delete it here. My apologies about that. Let's see, also here, it's not found. Okay, we are just going to create a new one now. Okay, all right, and then let me save. Okay, so let's go to our folder helpers. Let's see helpers. Okay, and then we are going to create a file, which is helper.ts, and that's about it. And then we copy and paste this. Let's see, do we have any other errors? As you can see, guys, we don't have errors. So what we are copying here is this function, send coded mail. Okay, that's the only thing that we are doing, actually, and it's an async function. Okay, and that is it. Okay, let's continue and see. If you want to visit this, the link will be in the description of this video. So let's continue, guys. Let's see. We are done copying this. Okay, and then let's get into the implementation. Okay, so in terms of the implementation, you can call this method on the browser on the client side. You can also call it on the server side. The way in which you call it on the server or on the browser, it's exactly the same. So for us, we're just going to call it from the browser. Okay, for now. Okay, but the method is the same on how you do it. Okay, the implementation. So as you can see, guys, the first thing that you need to do, you need to import this. Okay, you need to import this, and then you need to create an async function, which is send mail. Okay, and then from there, as soon as you hit this send mail, it will create this object. We will create our own, please note that this doesn't work, it's not valid, okay? We will create our own and then copy this as it is, basically. So what we need to do now, let's first import this, okay? Remember, guys, you are importing this from your own folder. Maybe you didn't use helpers, or you have put this folder in a different place. As you can see here, according to this code, this is being imported at Met Components, okay? So obviously we need to change that, because in your folder maybe you might not have Met Components and okay. So let's come back here. So now, where are we going to use this? Remember, we are going to use it on login. Okay, so we need to import it here on login. Okay, did I manage to paste that? Yes, okay. Let me remove this. So as you can see, guys, so this does not exist. Of course, we are not going to import it there, okay? Let's just, okay, not only I have copied, it looks like I have copied everything. Okay, let's just see, guys, my apologies about that. Undo. Let's say undo. Okay, as you can see, guys, okay. I'm back. So I'm thinking I want to only copy this line. Okay, I want to copy only this line. In fact, guys, let me make my life simple. Let me copy this method so that I can import this from the folder in my system. Okay, instead of importing this line, whereas I'm going to change it. Okay, my apologies about that. So let's just copy this method. So we are here on login. Let's just create this method somewhere here. Okay, before the render. Where is the render? Not here is the render. So before the render, let's paste this method here. So as you can see, guys, okay. So now let's come here and press control space, okay, so that we can, okay, this is this is the method that we have created. This is the one that we need to import. My apologies about that, the one with the red squiggly line. Remember me, I have put it under helpers, and then there is a helper.ts file, so I'm importing it from where I have saved it, okay? So now when you hit this async method, okay, this is the email that you want to use to send your email to, okay? So let's copy this, guys, okay? Let's copy this and paste it here, okay? As you can see, guys, this is the email that I want to send to. What is the header, okay? What do we want to say to the user? Let's just say new login, okay? New login. What is the subject? Let's say app login. Let's just say the subject. And we need to put the API key. Remember, I said this is the API key for me. Okay. Okay. You are going to have your own unique API key. And then from there, let's paste the API key here. Okay. And then after that, what do we want to say as a message? Let's see. When we are here, do we have the username? Yes, I think so. Okay. There is an active, we are on login. Okay. So that means we don't have an active username yet. Okay. Let's see. Okay. So in this login module, okay, where do we route to a different page when the login is successful? Check here, guys. Okay. It looks like on success here. That means this is only hit on success. We are pushing to home. So that means if we can call this send email here, okay, we have access to this data. Okay, let's see in this data what are the methods that we can get from there, or the values that we can get from there. It looks like it's any, okay, and it's possibly null. It looks like let's see, it has not been properly typed. Okay, So what we need to do first, guys, okay, we need to check in our modules. Where can we get the username? Because I want to create, what can I say? I want to greet the user by the name so that the user can be sure that the system is talking to me. Imagine receiving an email that says you've just logged in into your Spotify account, and it doesn't really have your personal detail or it doesn't have any information. So it won't be easy for you to know, was this intended for you or it's just a mistake? So that's why I'm saying it's very important, or it's crucial, that we have the username. Okay, so I'm going to try to get the username from here. If not, maybe we can make our lives easier, guys. Okay, maybe we can make our lives easier. Okay, maybe we can put this on the home. Okay, but if we put it on the home, that will be confusing, okay? Because, let's see, because this endpoint will be hit multiple times, okay? If we were hitting it once, I was going to put the email system here so that I know whenever you reach the dashboard, we will send an email. But sometimes you will go back and come here again. Does this mean we are going to send the message for login again? As you can see, guys, that's an error right there. Okay, so it's fine. Let's do it here. So the first thing that we need to confirm, we want to know, according to, remember, we are using a React query. So according to React query, what is it that they have inside this data? I think they also have some variables here, guys. Let's see, comma. I think they have some variables here. And these variables, they've got the email and the password. Okay, okay, cool. Since we are in login and the login deals with only the email and the password, it's much better. We are going to have the email, okay? We are going to have the email. So at least we've got something, guys. So let's just get variables here. Okay, do we really have to call this variable, or maybe we can call it user data? So that it can be meaningful, okay? User data, let's just call it user data. And then now I am sure that in this user data, I've got the email, okay? Okay, cool. So what I'm going to do for now, just as a test, let me just console.log the email, okay? So that we can be sure that we are receiving the email, user data dot email. Okay, I'm happy with this. And then let's go and log in. What we can do here, let's check what are these errors. What I'm going to do is possibly undefined. This is true. Okay, this is true. I think this code will run with these small errors. Okay, these are not the major errors. Obviously, we will fix them as we go. Okay, so what I want to know now, I just want to see. Let me look at. I just want to see if I am able to get the exact email. Okay. Let's see. This is the email that I want to get. Of course, let's just console.log. In the meantime, let me just type here Udemy. Okay. Don't forget, guys, I've got a course on Udemy. So you can come and support me here. Okay. You can come and support me here. I will show you now. Okay, I think I've got three courses at Udemy now. The third one, it's for free. It's a Figma course. So you can come here, guys. Okay, I've got this Next.js, ShredCN, UI, TypeScript course. And also I've got this React Advanced Component Composition. And it's hot and new, guys. Okay, so let's continue, guys, and see. This is not where I want to be. So I want to be here. So what I want to do here, I want to go to the console. Okay, I want to see if I am going to get the email. Okay, let's see. So am I going to get this email somewhere here? Let's see. It looks like maybe it says, okay, here is it, guys. Okay, here is it. My apologies. Here is it. Okay, as you can see, page.tx at 84. Let's just see. Is this line number 84? Line number 84. As you can see, guys, on line number 84, we are logging the email. So we've got the email now. Okay, cool. Now, what I want to do, I want to go to this send mail. I want to receive the email. Okay, let me just say user email. Okay, user email as string. Okay, so user email as string. Obviously, I have not used it, so I want to put on the body. Okay, your email. Now this was a different message, so let me just remove it. Okay, let's just say your email. Okay, your email, and then let's put the email. Okay, let's put that email, which is the one that we are going to receive. Okay, has just logged in. Okay, or your email, this email has recently logged in. Okay, I think this is fine. Okay, has just logged in. Okay, and that is it. Okay, and that is it. It doesn't have to be complicated. So as you can see, guys, we are getting there. So we are going to, and also the email, we are not going to type it here. Okay, obviously here this was just a sample. We are not going to type it because this email needs to be dynamic, okay, according to the user that has logged in. Okay, so we might as well pass it here. Okay, so it looks like it was the best choice to try to customize this message because I forgot about the email. Okay, so I'm happy with this. This is supposed to work. We've got everything. We've got the email, we've got the API key, and we've got the message. And what else? And then if email is success, okay, is email success, as you can see, this is supposed to return a boolean, I think. Okay, it looks like, yeah, a boolean is also there, but it's inside the object. Okay, let's see, obviously we are returning this object. Okay, let's just see if is, oh okay, now I understand why I have put this as a boolean. Okay, so if there is no data here that has been returned, this will be false. If it's null or undefined, it will be false. So the reason why I have named this is email success is because I'm not interested in the content. Okay, the content, whatever message that comes here, I'm not interested in it. I'm not going to use it. Okay, what I want to do, I want to know, was this successful or not? And how am I going to know that? If this data is null, this will be false. If there is something, whatever it is, it will be true. So that's why this is email success. Okay, so after that, there are possibilities that this can be null. Okay, as I'm telling you that if it's not successful, this can be null. So as you can see here, let's test if this is not true. That means we are going to console log this. So now let's deal with this error. This error is saying email is successful, is possibly null. Yes. So let's just put a question mark here. Okay. To say it might be here, it might not be here. And then dot message. Okay. Message does not exist. Obviously, this is some sort of a TypeScript error. Okay. By the way, we are not going to make use of, what can I say, the errors that come from the server. Okay, but for now, let's just console log them like this as they are. Okay, but here you can do whatever you want to do. You can alert and whatever, and then else you can do something else. Okay. Okay, so this might be here, this might not be here. Okay. Let's see. So if not true, this will be here. So when it's not true, when it's null, there won't be a message. This makes sense. Okay, I might as well delete this. Okay, because we know that this will be null. Okay, and then else you can do this. So the message is here when it's true, because we are going to get an object. Guys, I think for me that's all. So let's go to the emails and let's refresh here to make sure that we don't have any email that comes from there's no new email here. And then according to this API, okay, so according to this API, they have got the name of our application, which is Todo. So if we are receiving the correct email here, it's not supposed to come from where in terms of this? It's not supposed to come from coded mail. Remember, it will be coming from our app, or at least here, suppose we've got to do. So that's how we are going to differentiate between this one and the one that acts as if it's coming from us, okay? Because this API is for applications to notify, okay? So as you can see here, you just give it a name of the application and the email, okay? So this means that now when we are sending a message or an email with a specific API, that API key corresponds to a certain application name. In our case, it's Todo. So if everything works well, we are supposed to receive a new message which is going to come from Todo app, and then with the custom message that we have created. So let's just test it, okay? Let's just come here. I don't really need the mobile version, and let me log out. So suppose now when we are logging in again, we are going to get the message, okay? Let's see. And also let's just see the console log here. Okay, I think this is the email that we have console log on 84. And on success, suppose we've sent the email, but I don't see any console log at the moment here, but that doesn't matter. Let's just check if we got the email. Okay, let's just see if we got the email. Let me just refresh, but usually it just pops in here very, very, very quick. So I am tempted to say that something went wrong, okay, simply because we didn't even log anything here. Okay, that's not much of a problem. Let's just go back here. Remember, guys, we didn't call this, okay? This is my mistake, okay? My mistake. We didn't call this. As you can see, guys, it's gray. That means we didn't call it. So we were supposed to call it on success, okay? As you can see, on success, instead of console logging this, we need to call it and pass the email, okay? My apologies about that. Okay, we're supposed to call this and pass the email, okay? And now let's check and see. Okay, yes, okay. Now let's check and see, guys, okay? Test again, log out. Let's log out and then let's log in again, okay? Let's log in again. Okay, let's see. Do we have any console log? It looks like there was an error, okay? But it might be an error for something else. As you can see, it's being thrown by what? Let's see. It's being thrown by page.tx by 114, okay? Let's just quickly confirm if is does this error relates to what we were doing or not. 114. As you can see, guys, here we are sending an email. And where is our email? Maybe it's at 114. Let's see here. Okay, 114. As you can see, const is email await.send coded mail. So obviously we've got some errors. But let's just check, guys, okay? If what happened here, okay? Let's see, my apologies about that. So obviously there's something that is not right here. Let's see why there is an error here. Okay, we've got the email data. I'm happy with that. Okay, in my case, I already got Axios here in this application. Okay, so let's just quickly check, guys. Okay, the email is the email that we are going to get there, okay? Do we need to validate if really, really we got the email there, okay? Are there any possibilities that this email might be null? Okay, you never know, okay? You never know. So here, let's just type here if the email is true, okay? Now, I think we are just delaying on this email. You never know. So let's say if this is true, that means there is an email here. Okay. let's say there is an email. And also, the other thing that we might want to do, we might want to know more about the error that is coming back, so that it might happen, it's meaningful, it's going to tell us what is the problem, okay? So let's see, let's go back to where we are calling it. Okay, send email, and we are passing this email. Okay, and then let's see, obviously we validated that it must be true here, okay? So let's come back here, make sure the API key works and everything, and then let's check here. Here we are just passing the email, there is no error here, okay? So the challenge now is here, okay, cool. Now we want to see if is not okay. So now what we can do, guys, let's log, console log, this is success, okay? Is email success. Let's just console.log. You never know, in case maybe the server is telling us that the app is not registered, okay? Because sometimes we might think it's our mistake, whereas maybe there is an important message coming from the server, okay? This is send email, everything works well. Let's go back, guys, and test again. My apologies about that. This is supposed to be a walk in the park, okay? It's not supposed to be this complicated, okay? Maybe it's just that I'm making some few human errors, okay? Let's log in and let's see. Okay, it looks like we are getting the error again. And then let's see, my apologies about that. See, at send email page and object.success mutation at execute. Okay, cool. And then what we can do maybe as a test, okay? Now there might be a lot of possibilities for some mistakes, okay? What we can do, let's just send an email straight, okay? Something like this, guys, okay? Da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da, my apologies about that. Something like this. Okay, something like this. Let's just send the email straight. Okay, we've got the email, log in. And even here, let's just remove this. So now we are sending this email straight. And then let's not call this here. Okay, let's not call this here. Let's just call it where. Let's just call it when we click the on submit. Okay. Let's see. Where is the on submit? Let's just control here. Nope, this is not what I want. Find a form submit. Okay, the second one. Okay, so before you log in, we want you to call this. For now, let's just send an empty string because we don't really, the email is hard coded. Okay, so let's just see, guys. Okay, maybe the on success is giving us some issues. Okay, the on success is giving us some issues. Okay, let's just log in and let's see. Okay, there is an error, 217. All right, it looks like we are facing some challenges. Is our API key correct? Is our API key correct? Let's see. 471. Let's see. 471. Where is that? Okay, before render. Let's see, before render. Yes, our API key is correct. It's 471. Okay, one of the things that I don't understand is that why can't I get the error from the server? Okay, now I want to get the error from the server. Okay, you log in. This is app, API key, and this is this, and then We await this and pass email data. Okay, and let's go here. Okay, and then we're going to get the email data, send it there. Try this. Then, okay, let's see. Now, let's just console log the response. I don't think, does this have to be use client? Does it has to be use client? Does it have to? I think so, because we are using this on the client, okay? But let's first console log first. Okay, before, let's not do many changes at once, okay? Let's not do many changes at once. Log out. Okay, and then log in. Let's not do many changes at once. Okay, let's see. This is on. Okay, log in. Okay. Let's see. Status 200. So, meaning that from the server, it looks like email was sent successfully, as you can see, guys. Okay. And now we don't have the error. Okay. So let's see if the email has been sent successfully, and also try to find out what mistake were we making. Okay. What mistake were we making? As you can see, guys. Okay. To do app login. Okay. Okay. As you can see, new login. Your email has just logged in. Okay. So that means we are able to receive the email from to do app. Okay. But at this point in time, if I can be honest with you, I am not really sure what was the problem. I am maybe I will find it out, but I'm not really sure. Okay, you know, sometimes in coding things happen miraculously. Okay, it's like in a boxing fight, you've been saved by the bell. Okay, so to be honest, I can't really give you a reason why it was not working, because what I just did, I just console logged this, and that was it. Okay, so let's go back and see on our front end, maybe what was different, or I don't know. Okay, so let's just go back to the front end. You never know, maybe we were supposed to await for some certain things, but we forgot. Okay, so what I'm trying to say here is that the API works perfect, okay? It's just us. Maybe there's something that we have missed maybe a little bit, okay? So let's go back and check, guys, what we've just did, okay? This is the email sending part of it, okay? And what else? Let's see on form submit, okay? So as you can see, when we submit the form, we are sending this email, okay? Remember, this at least it's working, okay? And I'm happy for that. But we don't just send the email before we know if is it successful or not. So let's go back to the initial pattern or the strategy. Okay, let's just search for form mutation here. Okay, form mutation, as you can see. So we want to send this on success. Okay, so as you can see, on success, let's hit this endpoint again and see. Okay, because this must be sent on success. Okay, so I'm expecting to receive another email here from to do. Okay, so I might as well delete this one. Okay, so the endpoint is able to pick our app name based on, let me even delete this one. It's able to pick the app name based on our API key, okay? Which is, that's much better. And then let's see what we can do now, as you can see. And then let's log in. Okay, let's log in. And then let's see again what will happen. Okay, this takes some time. Okay, success is through, email sent successfully. Let's see. Okay, this is page 119 and this is page TX124. Okay, it looks like we are winning, guys. I don't really know what was the problem. I'm thinking maybe this, what can I say? Maybe this comes as null initially. So it's always sending a null email, okay? But let me just deal with my console logs, okay? First, let's start with the one on helper, which I don't believe we were supposed to even come here, okay? Did we remove the console log and two? Yes, it was here and I've removed it. Okay, so I won't advise to maybe make changes here. I am making changes here because I'm the one who wrote the API, or this is my API. Okay, so I know the code and but I won't advise to come and change things here. As you can see, it's working. And then let's go back to the email. Let's go back to the email, and then from here we are hitting this. And this takes us to here, okay? And then we are able to send the email. The only thing that I think might be a problem is this data, okay? Getting this email from here, okay? So let's go back here, guys. And then after that, let's send this data.email. Okay, if it gives us some errors, at least now we will know, okay? And also, let's just, for in case, when we get the error, I will put the console log again. Okay, so as you can see, now we are sure that if we are not winning, this is the problem. We need to deal with this. Okay, and let's see. Log out. Okay, refresh. Okay, and then let's log in. Okay, I think it's still loading here. Okay, let's log in again. Okay, let's log in. Let's see what is it going to display here. Okay, let's see. Let's see, is it me or it's refreshing or it's still processing? Okay, also there's some sort of a problem here, guys. Okay, there's some sort of a problem. Check here. This is dangerous. Email. What at gmail.com and password 12345. This is not supposed to happen, but obviously we are not going to fix it now. Okay, we will fix it later, but this is not supposed to happen. We can't expose people's password like this. Okay. Okay, let's see. Now everything it's successful. Okay. The email has been sent. Let's just check it. As you can see, guys, the email has been sent. If I can be honest, if this works, I wonder why it was not working before. Maybe you have watched me. Maybe I have made a typo, but I didn't notice. If I can be honest, guys, this was supposed to be this simple. You've got your helper here. You've got your helper here. You don't usually touch this. And then from then, you've got your method here, which is the one that you call to send the email, as you can see, guys. And then let's go to a definition of that. Okay, it receives the email. Oh, okay. Remember, guys, we have not used this email. Okay, still, we have not really, really won. Okay, let's test it for the last time. So we are still not sure if that null is working. Looks like I'm ahead of myself. Oh, I want to win, so I quickly get excited when I see that things are working. Okay, this is the time where we are actually testing for that null. Okay, it might happen at the first round, it sends a null message. It looks like it's working, guys, okay, as you can see. So, you've got this send email, which receives an email, and it puts an email here. And at the same time, it needs to put the email message here, the actual email. Let's do that. Let's do that and put the actual email here. I don't believe this might be the problem. Okay. So now let's just try to change something so that we can be sure. Okay. Your email. Okay. This is the email. So the one that we want to see as a proof that everything is working, it has got the email. Okay. Others don't have the email. Let's delete this and go back here. Okay. So let's log out and log in again, guys. Okay. My apologies about everything. Okay. Let's see. Trying to log in. Email sent successfully. Okay. Let's check in here. Here is the email, guys. Okay. Your email, what has just logged in. And that is it. We are done with sending the emails. Obviously, you can improve this message. You can send some links of your choice, whatever that you want to send. But what is important is that this API has been able to pick up our API key, and it has displayed the app accordingly, okay, because this is the app that is sending the message, okay, guys, okay. So let's continue, guys. Let's see what else we can do after that, okay. Let's just quickly test our adding a to-do or our creation part, okay. Let's say this task is after email, okay. Let's just select a date and then an image, and then this is the new image, okay. This is the new image, okay. I'm happy with that, and then let's register. Okay, this is ID number 4. Let's register. Okay, looks like everything has been registered successfully. Let's just look at local host and let's go there. Okay, do we have this, do we have this job, this task? Okay, this, yeah, it's a task on a to-do app. So do we have this task saved in our database? If yes, and then we're going to continue and do something else. This is not what I want. I'm looking for to do, and then I'm looking for tasks. Okay, after email, here is this task, guys. Okay, here is the image. This is the new image. I don't know why I wrote that. Okay, but it looks like we got this task. Okay, so the only thing that we didn't do, or we forgot to do here in this model, was the status. The tasks don't have status, okay? Is it complete, or is it done, or pending, or whatever? So we don't have statuses here. So what we want to do, we want to go to our Prisma. Let's go to our Prisma. Let's go to our Prisma. Where is our Prisma? Okay, is it me? Here is our Prisma, and we want to go to our schema. So we've got the users and we've got the tasks, okay. So what we want now, we want the status. Okay, we want the status. And the status is going to be a string, okay? The status is going to be a string. What I want as well, the status is not going to be just a string, if I can be honest, okay? It's not going to be just a string. I think it's going to be, let's see if there is something called enum here. I'm not sure. Okay, let's see, let me try this model. What will be model? Let's say status. Okay, I'm just testing something as model status. Okay, model status, and then do we have let's say status here? Nope. Whatever that I'm doing here, it's not going to work. So let's just ask ChatGPT to quickly help us here. What we want to do, I just don't really, or I'm not sure how to actually do it, but I know that it's possible. Okay. Let's just ask ChatGPT to, let's say, please add a field as a task status. As an enum, and that's it. Okay, is the field not there yet? Yes, let me remove the status here. Let me remove the status, okay, so that ChatGPT can think from a clean code. So I just forgot how to add an enum in Prisma, okay? And then I think it will also give us a possible list of statuses. As you can see, pending, in progress, complete, cancelled, okay? So, first of all, you define the enum, okay, and that is it. And then, where is the status? Status at default, pending. Let me fill the default value. Okay, so what links this to the enum, I think, is this task status. Okay, as you can see, guys, so instead of just copying and paste this, let's just try to do what I couldn't do, okay, which is now I can see that it's not that difficult. Okay, let's go back here. Let me undo and see where was I. Okay, it looks like I was somewhat correct. Okay, task status. Status. Okay, and then inside there, in fact, okay, it's enum status. Okay, now I see. Okay, it's not a model, it's enum status. Okay, and then from here, we just need to put all the possible values. Okay, what are our possible values? It's pending when it's just being created and you did nothing on it. Let's just have pending and complete. It's either it's pending, that means you haven't done the task, or it's or maybe we can put all these statuses as they are. Okay, let's put them as they are. Okay, so now we know it's enum. You define the enum here, and then you put the status as a type of this. And at default, okay, the default one is going to be, let me type a value that is not within this to check that the type safety. Okay, the safety, let me type RRR. The defined value RRR is not a valid enum. Okay, it looks like we are winning in terms of the types. Okay, as you can see, guys, so we have just created an enum. So that means the possible values of the status, it's pending, in progress, complete, and cancelled. Okay, so what we are going to do now, since we already have the data, okay, remember when I use to push changes to the database, I usually use Prisma DB push. Okay, and I told you that I didn't really care much about this information, whether it's deleted or not deleted, but it looks like now I care much about this information. So let's use another command to synchronize the database with the Prisma schema, okay, which is npx. Let's see, I hope I didn't forget it. Let's see, I think it's npx. It's npx Prisma, I think, migrate. Okay, migrate, and the name of the migration. So what we are adding now, let's say adding enum. Okay, or enum is not meaningful. Okay, let's just name it task status. Okay, Prisma migrate task status. Okay, so now we are synchronizing this schema with the database, and also we are doing it the right way. Okay, because when you push, it's more like you are creating a new structure. Okay, now it's not a new structure, so this means that if we use this way, should there be anything that breaks here, we can roll back. Okay, so let's try this one, guys. I'm not sure if the dash dash here is necessary. Okay, in this command. I'm not sure, but let's just try this one. And then if it gives us could not determine the schedule to run npx prisma migrate, let me try this for the last time. If it doesn't work, obviously prisma migrate dash dash, let's say task. Okay, status. Okay, I think this is the correct version of it. Still the login, the server, what. Okay, cool, not a problem. Let's just go here. Okay, run prisma migrate. Okay, I am still trying to learn this prisma thing. Okay, let's see what is the syntax. Okay, npx prisma migrate dev dash dash name. Oh, okay. Add task. Okay, let's see. Replace add task status with a descriptive name. Okay, so this is the part that I replace. Okay, npx prisma migrate dev dash dash name. Okay, I think now I understand. So let's see, npx prisma dev dash dash name. Okay, and then from there, task. Okay, status. Let's see, guys. Okay, thanks to ChatGPT, it looks like everything is running, everything is working. Let's see. Yeah, I think everything is working. Let's just check if here we've got the task status now after refreshing. Is it me or okay? Did we modify task? Yes. Description. I was hoping. Okay, let's just see. Okay, let's just see. Oh, it looks like there was an error. Okay, Prisma migrate. Okay, these one were errors, and we started here. Unknown command dev Prisma is a modern DB. Oh, okay, that dev had some problem. Let's see, generate da 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 da. Did I use generate or da da da? Let's check. Let's see, guys. Prisma migrate. Okay, yeah, I've used migrate. Then what is the syntax for Prisma migrate? Do we have anything here? Okay, not a problem. If even ChatGPT can't give us exactly what we want, but we are almost there. Prisma migrate. Let's just click here and then go to Prisma. Let's see, is this the right? Yes. Da, 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 da. Where are the commands? Where is getting started? Let's see. Okay, get started. Okay. Get started. ORM. Prisma. Get started. Quick start. Let's see. Okay, I'm looking for that command, Prisma install. Okay, npx prisma migrate dev a name. Okay, it looks like, guys, it's the same. Okay, but let's just copy and paste it this time. Okay, npx prisma migrate dev dash dash and then task. Go back to what we want to do. Task status. Okay, task status, and let's see. It looks like now things are happening. Okay, we need to reset MySQL database to do at what. Do you want to continue? Yes. Okay, even if I can lose the information, I don't think I mind that much. So everything has been created. Let's just double check what was some sort of the mistake that we did. This is the last command. Let's check our previous one. What was the difference? Okay, I forgot migrate here. This is Prisma dev, so this was my mistake. Okay, npx prisma migrate dev. Okay, now I see. Okay, that was my mistake. So let's go back here, guys. Let's refresh here. Suppose now we've got the status. Okay, obviously it looks like we lost everything. Really, I don't mind much about that. So when you are creating some, what can I say, an important application, developing an important application, please take note of these. Okay. You don't have to lose all your data, but since we have used migrate, we can even roll back if we want to, but in this case I don't, there's no need. Okay, so that means now we are able to have some statuses here, and we are having a default which is pending. Let's just test that, guys. Okay, not here, let's test it here. Okay, let's say new one. Okay. Okay, task status. Okay, let's, this to do, it's even saying register. Okay, we need to fix that. Okay, let's check, and then let's go back here. Oh, is it me or what? Is this a to do? Yes. Is this a task? Yes, but now we don't have is it running? I don't think the development is running. Okay, let's see, npm run dev. Okay, my apologies about that, guys. The development was not running. Okay, and then let's go back here. New one. Okay, let's just make sure everything is well. Looks like it's ready. Let's see. Okay, let's go back and refresh. Is it me or what? Now let's go back and try to debug. Okay, do we have an error? Looks like we have. Okay, it looks like we have. That's not much of a problem. Okay, compile API to do 200. Okay, let's refresh here on the to-dos. Let's try it for the last time. And let's check the network. Okay, let's see. To-dos, looks like it has been created, as you can see. Am I on the right place? ID, task title, users. Oh, okay, I see, I see. We don't have any data here, even the users. Okay, so now I see. So we are trying to save a task for a user that doesn't really exist. So that means the system doesn't know this guy anymore. That's not much of a problem, guys. Let me just take a quick water break. I will come back now so that we can continue. Okay, thank you so much for your patience and understanding. Okay, so as you can see that this was an error. I thought this meant that everything is successful, but at least it's an understandable error. We just need to create at least one user. Okay, I will be back now. Okay, guys, I am back and I am refreshed. Okay, so let's see what we can do from here. Okay, what we want to do now, we want to register a user. Okay, so let's just look out here. At least let's register one user. Okay, I'm not sure what might have happened here. Let's wait for it. Okay, guys, please don't forget, I've got this awesome course here. And also in this course, there's a lot available for free, okay, for preview. Okay, there's a lot, guys, okay. So you can come and watch here, okay, and learn, even if maybe for now you can afford to buy it, but there is a lot available for free, even in this course, in this one. Okay, I think 80% of this course is for free, this one. So you can just come here and learn something and then end where you can. Okay, as you can see, guys, you see, starting from here, I think these are available for previews. How many lectures? Where do I start to see the locked lectures? Or maybe to me, everything is available. Okay. I am not sure, but there is a lot available here. Okay. Enough about that. Let me close it because maybe it might start playing. Okay. So let's see what we can do, guys. This is not where I want to be. I want to be here and I want to register. Okay. Okay, I want to register and I want to register this guy. And what is the password? 12345. The name, it's Matt. Okay. And let's add the image. The name is Matt. Register. And let's see. As you can see, guys, now Matt is registered and we want Matt want to create a task. All right, and then let's say I'm not sure. Go to school. I'm not sure why must I go to school. Maybe I'm not educated. I'm not sure. Okay, let's go back here and attach an image and just testing. And let's save the task. Okay, I'm assuming the task has been saved. Let's refresh here. The status is supposed to be pending. Where is the status? As you can see, guys, the status is pending. Okay, so what I'm going to do, I'm just going to create another task. Okay, maybe three so that two can be pending and one can be some sort of complete or a different status. Okay, so let's go back here. Code my app. Okay. Let's see. Make a different image and what image can be. Let's take this image. And then coding my new app. Okay. Let's register this. And then what else? I'm not sure if to be yourself it's a task. Okay. Let's see. Is it a task? I am not sure. Okay, let's just change this image. Put this one. All right. And then that was too quick. Okay. As you can see, guys, we've got some three tasks here. Okay, so what I want to do, I want to change one of these, let's say to what? To completed. Okay. And the other one to canceled. Okay, to cancel. The reason why I'm doing this, I want to prepare for the dashboard. Okay. So as you can see, guys, here we just need to remove this and only leave save here. But for now, it's those some sort of minor tweaks, okay? And also we need to delete or clear this when we are done creating a task. My apologies about that. That one, we will come back to it. So when you come here, okay, we need to have some stats card according to our statuses, okay? How many tasks are pending, how many tasks are completed, how many tasks, how many tasks, how many tasks. So let's quickly do that. Let's start from the back end. Okay, let's create a query to get the tasks by this user. Okay, the task by this user and what by this user, and that is it. Okay, and that is it. And then when we get these tasks, what are we going to do with them? Do we have to look in the front end and check this, which is, I think that's too much for the front end. Okay. Or maybe in the query, we are going to select task where this ID is this guy and the status is complete, which is I'm going to get only 24. And then, and also make another query where the status it's, where the status it's whatever. This is somewhat confusing. Okay. So let's say in the back end or in the database, we've got these tasks. Okay. Let's say thousands, okay, thousand of them. So if I get the thousand and then look in the front end so that I can display here the ones that are active, the ones that are not active, as you can see, it might be time consuming to do that in the front end. Okay, it might be time consuming. Okay. This means that I need to, let's say we do that with Prisma with the query. Okay. Is it possible if I can get a query that will read like an object that will tell me? I think it's possible. Okay, an object that will tell me that pending tasks, it's 24, completed tasks, it's 25, and I think that is possible so that I can use that object instead. Okay. My last resolution or my last resort was to render this on a server. Okay. This section as it is, I was going to change it to be a server component, and then I was going to do all the complex task or time consuming or resource consuming task there and just display this as HTML. Okay. But let's first try to think of the query approach, because I think it's going to make use of the back end and it's going to be efficient. Okay. I believe that is possible, but we need to know how to. I'm not sure how to ask ChatGPT on how to do it. Check here, guys. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to take this as is, including the pending, so that ChatGPT can know that we've got this this enum. Okay. And then I'm going to ask ChatGPT, please create a Prisma query to get the sum totals of tasks. Okay, tasks. Okay, grouped. Okay. Grouped by the status. Grouped by the status. Okay, I think this makes sense. Please create a Prisma query to get the sum totals of tasks grouped by status. I think this is meaningful. Okay. Unless ChatGPT really, really needs some explanation. Okay, so I want to know, how could I get a query where I will get back pending 7 in, let's say, completed 10, and so. So let's see. Prisma, create new Prisma client, get tasks count by status. It looks like you are getting the const task count is going to await prisma.task. Yes, group by. Okay, I can see group by status, group by the status field. I'm happy with that. Count all is true. Count all the tasks in each group. Good. And then return that. Okay. I think this is fine. And then you call this dot, then you get the data, and then you console log. Okay, guys, I think this is what I wanted exactly. Okay, so let's see what we can do, guys. We just need to edit this, okay, because we are getting task count. Okay, await prisma.task.group by. Okay, but what I want also, I want where ID. Okay, obviously this might give me tough time if I might want to fiddle. Okay, so let's just tell ChatGPT, please include where ID, or let's say where user ID. Okay, so that we can get a perfect query, and then we can just go there and use it. Okay, so how do you include where ID? Because we want to select for a specific ID. Okay, details for user ID. Okay, user ID, that's what we're going to get as a number. Okay, task count is await Prisma tasks group by. I'm happy with that. And then from there, where task is this and this. Okay, cool. Guys, this is Money in the Bank. Are we recording? Yes. Okay, so this is Money in the Bank. Let's continue. So what we are going to do, we are at least, I think this method is the most efficient. Okay, the front end does nothing and even the back end does nothing. Prisma does everything. Okay, now as you can see, so we want to create an endpoint here. Where is the API endpoint? Okay, and then the endpoint will be tasks. Okay, tasks. Okay, tasks by. This is it. These are tasks by user, but you don't get the actual tasks. You get the numbers. So in a way, we are counting here. So task count by user. Okay, so that somebody can have an idea of, we are not getting the actual list of tasks. We are counting the number. It's like we're getting the sum totals. Okay, so let me continue. And then route, okay, dot ts. I'm happy with this. Okay, cool. This looks familiar. I think we have a backend API that looks more or less like this. We are just getting data from the backend, but at the same time, let's just type this backend from scratch for the sake of learning. First of all, is it going to be a post or a get? Let's make it a get. It makes sense if it's a get. So we are going to create here const. When you are in a server, always await things or async. Okay, const get. Apologies about that. Const get. In fact, we need to export it. Export const get. It's an arrow function. All right, it's an arrow function. It's an arrow function. Let's make it async. Okay, cool. And then we are going to receive a request. Okay, we're going to receive a request as a next request. Okay, after receiving a request as a next request, what I want to do, I want to get the, what is it that I want to get? I want to get the ID, the user ID. Okay, so const user ID. Let's make sure that the user ID is exactly the same as in our schema, right? Yes. Let's see. Yes, let's just do that. Where is our Prisma schema? Prisma schema. Okay, where is task? Yes, task. Where is user ID? I think here is referred to as the creator. Okay, I think the user here is referred to as a creator. As you can see, references ID field from users. Okay, so let's name this the creator. Okay, we don't want to keep on changing variable names unnecessarily. And then I want the request, the rec. Okay, this one, this variable, request dot json. Okay, I want to get the JSON from it. Okay, and request.json. I think here I can. Okay, let me destruct first. Okay, I need to destruct this. Taskbar does not exist on promise. Yes, it does not exist. I should have awaited it. Okay, and then what else? Okay, let me continue. This can be null. Okay, that means it might not be there. Let's say if this is null. Okay, if this is null, And then that means if it's not true, and then let's create a response. In fact, it's a next response, not just any response. It's a next response dot JSON. And then let's just say that an error is going to be an error. And then no user ID. Okay, no user ID. Most important thing, you must pass the status code, the HTTP status code. This is very important, guys. Please go and learn HTTP status code or response code so that you can learn to respond with the correct status code, because the browser make use of these status codes and it makes some decisions according to them. So they have to be meaningful. So what I know for now is that status 400 has got something to do with the requester, with the user supplying wrong information. So here, this request has got something to do with the user, which is the client, supplying wrong information. Which information is that? It's the creator ID or the user ID. It's not there. So this is the client fault, not the server fault. So 400 makes sense. And then let's continue. Okay, so now, guys, I won't advise this, okay? Don't continue encode too much. I used to do this at first, and I will have, let's say, 16 bugs to fix, and the other one is dependent on the other one, and the other one is dependent on the other one. It takes time to fix that, okay? So I think this is clean and simple for now. It can help us to see, are we able to get this? Are we able to get that? And then we are going to return this like as soon as possible, okay, as quick as possible. And then if all goes well, we're just going to change this to success, and then we are going to just type here happy, and then the status will be 200. My apologies about that. The status will be 200, as you can see, guys. So let's try to hit this endpoint. Okay, let's try to hit this endpoint. Where are we hitting this endpoint? We are hitting this endpoint at home, not create. Let's see, dashboard. Where is dashboard? This is dashboard, or it's home straight. Okay, it's just home. So home and pages of home, that's where we want to be. So what we want to do, I think we are supposed to create a React query, okay, or a TensorStack query. So let's query, okay. So where do I do this? At form load, or when this form is loading. Obviously, I'm not going to just do it here. I need to be very, what can I say? I need to really think about it, because React can trigger some unnecessary re-renders based on my logic and how I think. So for now, let's just create a query only. Okay, so what we are doing here, we are using TensorStack query to help us with querying from the database, okay, or connecting to the API, okay, the endpoint. Now, let's say const get count, get task counts. Okay, or count or task totals. Okay, task totals. Okay, is equal to, we want to use TensorStack query, use equal to use query, not queries. And then we are going to pass an object here. My apologies about this. Let me zoom in so that you can see this properly in case you are viewing this from a mobile phone. And then we are going to pass an object, and this object has got a query function. Let's start with a query key. Okay, I think this is an object, a query key, which is, I usually put the same function as the query key, okay, to make my life easier. And then I have to put a query function, okay. A query function. What is a query function? A query function is just I just have to return a promise, okay? That means we need to fetch the data, okay? Obviously, fetching data returns a promise. I've got my own library, which is a metfetch, which is part of the met components, okay? So let's first, okay, this is use client already. I'm happy with that. So let's type here const get. Is this okay? Recreate read update and tilde. Okay, in metfetch we've got a read method that help us to read things from the database or read things from the API. So I'm going to use here use metfetch as it is. So we are going to use this read, okay, as you can see. So we are going to return, okay, return, let's see, let's make this async. Yes, let's make this async, and then we are going to return await. We are going to await this, and then we are going to use get. Okay, and then on the get we need to pass an endpoint. I think that's it when it comes to read. Okay, my apologies about this. This is not get. This is read. Okay, we are reading from the database. We pass the endpoint. And what is our endpoint? Our endpoint is where's API? Okay, is task by ID. Okay, sorry, it's a task count by user. Okay, so let's put here API forward slash this. Okay, we want to hit this, and then as soon as we hit it, okay, that means we are going to get the data. And before, let's see when is this going to get the data. Okay, this is very important when it comes to React. Okay, let's see. I think first of all, 10 stack query takes care of the use effect. Okay, so this means that we don't really have to use a use effect here, so that when the component has loaded, so that we can trigger this. Okay, I think that's why we are using 10 stack query. We are trying to use it or ask it to some sort of do the boilerplate code and some sort of the use effect thing. Okay, so point number one, this is perfect. We don't need the use effect, because I was thinking that, okay, we need to make sure that we run this as soon as this component loads. Okay, so guys, we're not going to use the use effect unless we are encountering an error. Okay, so use query does everything. So this means that now we've got the data, okay, from the API. And then what we want to do, we want to display that data, okay? Let's just console.log that data, okay? In fact, at this point in time, it's not the data necessarily, okay? But it's the response from the API, okay? Obviously, in terms of us, what is the response? Here is the response. It's either it's going to be this or it's going to be this, okay? I forgot something, okay? When we come here, we need what? We need the ID, okay? And I didn't pass the ID. So if you look at here, we must pass the ID on the front end. Let's go and do that. Let's see what we want to do. Go to the front end, home. Where is home? Okay, home, and then go to page. And then we need to pass the ID. How do we get the ID? If we are using met component, we've got a hook. Let me put it here. We've got a hook here, const. I think we're going to destructure active user here, but we're going to come back with it. Let's use active user. Okay, as you can see, here is the hook. This is supposed to give us the Is it active user or user data? Okay, let's see. It's user data. Okay, so we are going to destructure the user data. So the first thing that we need to do first before console logging the data from the API, let's just get the user data first. Who is logged in? Okay, so it looks like to me we are supposed to some sort of console log something here. Okay, and that thing is supposed to be the user data. Okay, as you can see, guys, here is the active user. This is the user data. So we are able to get the user data. So what we want here, where is the ID? We want the ID, which is 1. Okay, so that means after getting this user data, we need to pass it here. Okay, let's see. So what do I want to do? Because I need to think React here, meaning that I need to do things the React way. So we are going to get this user data here, and this query will need it. Okay, we will need the ID. Okay, I'm happy with that. What else do I want to do? First of all, let me try to pass this query data. Okay. By the way, this query data, okay, this query data, I will have to pass it and I will have to receive it here. Okay. I will have to receive it here. And let's say here I'm receiving user ID. Okay, I'm receiving it as a string. Property user ID does not exist here. Okay, cool. I understand this. Okay. I understand this. Property user data does not exist. Let's see. It does not exist on type query key string. Okay, not a problem. Apologies about that. Now, let's see, what am I going to do? What am I going to do? It looks like to me, I need to wrap something here. Okay. I think I need to wrap something here. It's either I wrap this, let's see. I don't think this is what I have to wrap necessarily. It looks like to me I have to wrap. What if I can wrap this with a function? Okay. What if I could wrap this with a function, and in that function I will receive as a parameter, or yes, as a parameter, and then I will receive the ID. And then once I get the ID, that means inside that module, that function, the user ID will be available. Okay. And if it's available, I don't really have to pass it here. Okay. As you can see here, we are getting some funny things, which I don't know what are they. Okay. Okay. Maybe a second option will be to move this out. Okay, we don't really need it. In terms of this read, I think this read passed. I can get a second parameter. Okay, let's say read unknown, record endpoint, and params. So this read do get the params. So what are the params? The params are what is our endpoint expecting? Okay, let's go back here. Our endpoint is expecting, I think, a task ID or something, but we can quickly check. Okay, where's the API? Okay, our endpoint is expecting a task creator, okay, which is an ID. Okay, so we can pass this task creator. Where is home, and his page. Okay, so we can pass the task creator here and then pass it as what? Okay. What if maybe we can take this user data, because this user data has got the ID, user data dot user ID, I was user data, I was expecting you to give me some possible options, but it looks like you are not, simply because you are of user data unknown. That is understandable because I didn't pass the type. So that's why I don't get the types here. Okay, cool. I think when we created the user data, we have a global type, okay, which is active user. I think we have a type like that. Where is it? I think it's this one. Okay, let's just check what are the possibilities. Is it the same as that one? Okay, email verified, ID, image, name, and role. I don't think it's the one that we are looking for. Okay, let me show you the shape of data that we are looking for. I hope I am still console logging. Check here, guys. The one that we're looking, the type that we're looking for, it has got active. So it looks like we've got a misleading type here. Okay, I need to deal with that. So let's just see user action. Nope. Okay, active. Let's see. Active user type, I think it's this one. So I need to go and delete this one, active user. I think active user type is the one that I want. Okay, and it has been globally declared. So as you can see, guys, this is what we want, and we want the ID here. So let me go to the types definition, and we've got active user type here. I think the user type that was confusing comes from met component. So I'll need to revise met component and delete that one, okay? Because it must not even appear here because it's confusing us. So we are looking for this one. All right, where do I want to be? I want to be on home and page, okay? So as you can see, guys, we can get this. So it looks like this is going to work without, excuse me, without me trying to wrap things. Okay, we are going to get this parameter from this data. Okay, cool. Now let's think in a React way. This might take time, okay, to get back. So, and also there is a possibility that this user data might be null. Okay, meaning that here we can pass a null, okay, as you can see. Okay, we can pass null to here, and things won't work. Okay, with 10 stack query, okay, which with React query, there is an option where we can tell this query not to execute up until this data is valid. Okay, up until a certain variable is valid. I think we can do that by passing another parameter here, which is enabled. Okay, which is enabled. So enabled can be a boolean. Okay, enabled is equal to true. It means that it's going to execute. Enabled equal to false. It means that it's not going to execute. Okay, that means this is not going to jump by executing. It will need this variable to change to true before it execute. Makes sense, right? Yes. Now let's try to be clever. We want you to execute on, because you are depending on this user data. Okay. We want you to execute on this user data. Option definite. Okay. Let's see. Okay. We want you to execute on this user data. So this is telling us that user data is possibly null, of which that's true. Okay, of which that's true. So let's see. Let's do this. Okay. Remember, I said this is a Boolean value. It's true or false. And this is more like a data. Okay, as you can see the shape of this. Okay, as you can see. Okay, it's active user type. This is the shape. And when you try to get this, you get a number or undefined. So as you can see here, you are not getting true or false, but you are getting a number or undefined. So we need to find a way to convert that number or undefined into true or false. How are we going to do that? Check here. When this is defined, this is going to be true, okay, because there is something. When it's undefined, it might be false, okay? But that doesn't happen automatically because at this point in time, this is number or undefined, okay? Cool. And then what we need to do, we need to some sort of play around with, what can I say, reversing, I'm not sure, the conditionals, okay? Or what can I say? Let me first do this small thing. It's not a hack, but it's just a trick, okay? So, look at this. These conditions evaluate to true, but not immediately, okay? Not immediately. So, in order for it to evaluate to true, let's just use this not. Okay? We are using not. So, let's read this, okay? Or let me do this so that it can be clear. We are saying here, if we are getting a value, this is a value. It doesn't evaluate to true. It's a number, okay? If you are inverting, okay, or flipping that, okay, meaning that you are saying not a number, okay, or not something, whatever it is, okay, you are saying you are not what you say you are. If you are saying you are a Boolean value, you are not that, which is false. If you are saying you are a person, you are not a person, which is going to be false. So as you can see, the idea of Booleans come as a result of this not reversing the condition, okay, or the state or the truthiness, okay? So if you are a number, you are undefined, you are supposed to be true, okay, but not by default. You only start to be true, or you only start to change to a Boolean once we some sort of condition you, okay? Meaning that not true will be false. Let's test if this might give us what we want. If there is a number here we want you to trigger, which is number, it's true, okay? There is something. Then we want you to trigger when the number is true, but not true, which is this is a guy that reverses everything. Not true is false. So when this condition is true, this guy will change it to false, okay? When there is a number here, this will be true and not true will be false. Now let's reverse it again to true. Change it again to true, okay? So if there is a number here, there will be not true here, which will be false, and not false, again, not false will be converted to true. So now by putting these two things here, two exclamation marks, you are converting an object which was supposed to be a string, a number, or whatever, but in a way, in terms of coding, that's true, it's truthy. You are trying to convert it to a Boolean equivalent. So when it's available, this will convert it to true. When it's not available, it will convert it to false. Let me run you through this for the last time, okay? Let's say we have null here. Not null, the first one, it's true. Not true, then becomes false. This works because it's null. Let's say we've got a number, which is that's true. Not a number, it's false. And not false, it's true. So this will convert this. It's either going to be true or false. So let's go back to what we're trying to do. We are loading for the first time. We are depending on data, okay? The active user. The active user, we can't just know from the get-go, okay? If this is an active user, we can't know from the get-go. This needs to go and do some certain tasks and things which it might fail. Okay, so meaning that we are not going to get this from the get-go. Okay, meaning while this is not true, okay, while this is not true, don't execute. As soon as this becomes true, please execute. Okay, now let me just hint you with something. Okay, and what can I say? Let me just hint you with something. With React, when you want to keep the states of variables, okay, when you want to know or when you know that the state will change in the future, or after some time you are expecting it to change, the best way to do that is to use the use state. Here we are using React like normal JavaScript. We've got an object, we've got a variable that we are expecting it to change, and we are listening to it here, or we are waiting for it here to change its state. Okay, the best way to do it is to use a use state, because use state is detecting the change in states. It's ideally for that in React, but for the sake of testing here, we're just going to do it like this. But if we are facing some difficulties, we are going to opt for use state, okay? Because use state will never miss the changes, okay? There is no way with use state that we can go here with null, check it's null and it's going to be false, and we continue. As soon as this change, we don't come back and hit this one, okay? So when we are doing it this way, chances are that might happen. We come here, put null here. What if this update, since this is not a state variable, it doesn't update the whole system, because it's not a state variable. It's like we are casual here with React. We are just treating it as normal JavaScript. Okay, so guys, with all the theory and all the complicated thing being said, let's just test. Testing is the only thing that will help you to, I'm not sure, gravitate towards where you want to go. Okay, so what I want to console log first here, I want to console log the data. So as a bonus, okay, let's just also console.log the get tools, okay, this guy, the get task totals dot what is it, pending or is fetching, let's try with is fetching, okay, to see is it working on the background and when is it going to finish on the background. So this is like the state of this guy. When this guy is busy working something, this is fetching will be as will be false, and then when it's done, then it will be true. So it's like we are checking what is this guy busy with, which is the one which is busy for connecting to the API, and then if he is done, what do we have here? Okay, we are trying to test what is going on here on the data, and how does that relate to the state of the fetching method. Okay, I think this is bulletproof. Let's go and check here. Okay, this one was the active user. Are we still console logging it? I don't think so. We are not console logging the active user here. We are still, let's delete it, because now it's going to confuse us. Okay, what else? Okay, we are console active user. I don't want that. Okay, let me change it to data. Okay, which is the result of this guy. So this is the result of this guy, and this is the state of this guy. So let's just refresh here and see. All right, it looks like there was a hook. As you can see, guys, okay, we've got undefined and we've got false, we've got undefined, we've got false, we've got undefined, we've got false. So what we are learning from here first is that the fact that we are hitting this in terms of execution doesn't necessarily mean we are automatically getting the value immediately. Okay, the fact that we are hitting this even here, that doesn't mean we are getting the value immediately. So I think that's the best way to think about React. Okay, there are means to, number one, waiting for the data. Make sure that you, let's say you create a use state variable where you are going to make sure that as soon as the data become available, you need to update. Okay, so that's what we are learning from here. As you can see, check here, guys. Okay, it started by being false. What was false? This was pending. Now I'm not really sure which one is pending and which one. So let's say is fetching is false, and then this undefined false, is fetching is false, so it's undefined, is fetching is false, undefined, And then I think at some point is fetching changed, okay, to true. And we got undefined, and still we got undefined. As you can see, this is obviously 10 stack query keeps on trying, okay, keeps on trying, okay. So it looks like to me there is an internal server error, okay, to start with, okay. To start with, our server doesn't return what we really want, okay. So let's go back there and check what might be the problem. So let's come back and check to the API, and then on the API, let's see. We want to get this, we want to be here, okay. Remember, I said don't try too much and write a lot of things here, okay. Don't write a lot of things here because you might fail. So let's see. The first thing that we want, we must export this. The second thing, we must return the response. Okay. We always need to return the response. Okay. As you can see, this is still clean, and we are able to some sort of catch the mistakes or the bugs that we are making. Imagine if we would have written like 50 lines. Okay. It was going to be difficult for us to know if are we winning or not. Okay. Remember, I am not a genius, or there is no one who is a genius. Okay. It's only the computer that is an obedient server, not the human mind. So you must always know that you've got some limitations in terms of memory and other things. So take things step by step. So as you can see, guys, we have identified an error and we have managed to fix it. And then let's go back. And then in our logging, okay, let's go back to where I want to be on home, and then on home, I want to be here on page. Here, not only we want to console log these, but we want to identify these, okay, because I didn't really know which one is which. Let's say is fetching. Are you fetching something? You are going to display this, and then here we can say fetched data, or let's say data, okay. Let's say response, okay. API data, let's say API data. Okay, I think there is another value that I want to log, okay, and that value is is this guy here, okay, this guy here. I also want to know when does this guy appear, or when does it show up, okay. Console log. A console.log, okay, user data.active, user.active ID. So let's say the user ID. Okay, my apologies about that. I should have put this in here, user ID. Okay, so let's run through this, guys, and for the last time, just to refresh our mind. Okay, now logically, based on what I see, this guy is not going to be immediately executed. So we are not going to fetch the data. What does that mean? It means that the fetch data thing, which is this one, it's for some time, it's going to be undefined, or as you can see, okay, if you are not fetching, you are supposed to be undefined, okay. The next one, sorry, I want to take only this one, okay. So the next one, it is fetching. Okay, remember also is fetching, it's not going to quickly fetch. Okay, why? Because it's dependent on the user ID. As long as the user ID is false, these two guys are not going to execute. So we want number one, this one guy to execute. That's why I'm going to point it as number one. As soon as this guy execute, this guy is supposed to be number two because it's going to fetch. The is fetching is going to change, and then this is the third guy that is supposed to be true, that is supposed to return something. So this guy, if this guy is null, what does that mean? All of these guys, they are false, they are null, as you can see, until this guy has got something. And then once this guy has got something, then we will start to fetch. And then we'll start to get data back. Okay. I hope you get that one. So let's go back here, guys, and refresh again and let's see. Okay. User ID is undefined. Is fetching is equal to false. I was expecting that. Number three, API data is equal to false, undefined. As you can see, guys, this is doing exactly what we said, or according to our logic. User ID is undefined. It means that number two, is fetching, you are supposed to be false. How could you fetch if there is no user data? I'm happy with this. API data, it's undefined because you have not fetched. User ID, again, still on the second try, this is undefined. Is fetching is false. And user ID, now, this is very important, meaning that when you hit this, okay, when you hit this, this doesn't mean you are going to get this immediately. Remember, I told you we've got some null values that we need to handle. Maybe if you might want to know, how can I know if a function will take time and it might return null, it's not going to give me the exact thing that I want. You might as well go to the function definition and try to understand maybe what it does. Okay, let's see. As you can see, this use state active, user data active, active dot then. Once this has got a dot then, that means there is some sort of a promise here. Okay, there is some sort of a promise here, as you can see. So let's say return user data. Okay. Here we are returning the user data. Yes. Now I was trying to find a way of how could I indicate without even coming here to know that this will take time. Okay. But based on this execution, it must give you the data or null, not necessarily give you the promise, because if I can return a promise here and give you the promise, it means that you need to await the promise. I think that will be a lot of code for the other developer to take care of. So I'm happy with this, with what I did here. So as you can see, guys, this dot then is telling you that it's a promise based function, so meaning that it's going to execute and take some time. I hope you got that one. And then let's go back to the browser. Okay, first let's go back to where we are in terms of home. Okay, we were here, so I'm happy with these consoles. Okay, they are reflecting exactly what we want. Now when the user data is one, what am I expecting? I am expecting this to kickstart. But it looks like this is still false and this API data is still false. Okay. Now we started again. The user ID was one and is fetching, started to kickstart. It looks like I'm lying. Is fetching is still false and API data is still undefined. Okay. And then let's see. And then how did we come about to hitting this endpoint then? Okay, how did you come about to hitting this endpoint with task creator equal to one and we return an internal server error? Okay, user ID is still one, is fetching also is still false. So as you can see, fetching an API data has been false. Okay, and it's understandable because number one, we are getting some errors here. Okay, we will come back to why these ones are not. Is fetching now is true? When did is fetching changed? Okay, let's see. Is fetching was false here. Okay, so after that, I think it started to hit this endpoint, and then is fetching was true. Is fetching was true. Okay, but it looks like at the moment in time, we are struggling with the endpoint. Okay, that's not much of a problem, guys. Let's go to our endpoint. Now we need to make our endpoint as simple as possible. Okay, because as you can see, it looks like we are not, it's not returning something. Okay, let's see. Export. Okay, we're exporting it. I like that. It's const, yes. It's get, I'm happy with it. Is it an async? Yes, it's an async. I'm happy with that. As soon as we get in here, I want us to return success, happy. Okay, no other thing, no awaiting request.json task, no nothing. We hit this endpoint, we return this as it is. Okay, let's see. This is happy. Let's even type it with capital letter. Okay. This is supposed to be that simple, because we don't want to go and fiddle with the front end. Whereas the reason why the front end is misbehaving, it's because of the back end. So after it has done loading, whatever it is, it must respond with something. I'm not expecting errors here. Okay. Then I will continue to work on the front end. As you can see, guys, now, when everything goes well, okay, as you can see, let's just check our table here. User ID was undefined. Everything was undefined. Okay. User ID is 1. At this moment in time, it's still undefined. I don't really mind much about that. Okay. This was undefined. I don't really mind much about that. The second time, user ID is 1. Now, the is fetching started working because of this value, as you can see, exactly as we wanted. Is fetching is true. I'm happy with that. If is fetching is true, suppose when you are done fetching, you give me something. And this is giving me success is equal to happy. Okay. So I think everything is working well. Okay. The other thing that you must look at here to check if you don't have some re-renderings, if you've got some numbers accumulating somewhere here, it's either it's going to be this message or this user, or maybe here number of errors, they keep on increasing, maybe 10, 12, 13, 21. So you must know that you've got too many re-renderings. Okay. So also one may ask why these things, it looks like they are repeating. Obviously, these are necessary re-renderings. Some of them, they are caused by React. It has got some initial 1 to 2 to 3 time re-rendering when you are starting, more especially in development. And then here also, the React query will, what can I say? The React query will do some refetching. Okay, so it will refetch the data, so it's not like it fetch once and it fails, so it keeps on counting. I am somewhat happy with this, okay, because it delivers the results that I want. So let's continue with this until we feel like maybe it's delaying us, okay, and then from there we are going to introduce the use state. Okay, so if we were to introduce the use state, how would we go about that? Let's go back to here just to see if this is not where I want to be. I want to be, is this home? Yes, not create. I want to be here. Okay, so what could we change if we were introducing the use state? That will mean we are going to have a state here that will check for the change of this data. Okay, it's going to check for the change of this data. As soon as this data changes, and then instead of using this as an active ID, we are going to use that state variable. Okay, maybe that might... But I don't have a problem with this code. If you look at it, it's not like it's failing multiple times. Okay, because check here, user ID is undefined, everything is false. I'm happy with that. User ID is 1. It's only this initial render where it was supposed to be true. Okay, but it didn't from the get go. Okay, this is the first one. As you can see, also here on the second one. Okay. User ID, it's 1, but it's still getting false. It's not fetching. I think maybe on the third time, it started kickstarting. Okay. Maybe let's try to eliminate these possibilities. Okay. With the use state. Okay. As you can see, it's twice. Suppose here it has picked up that this has changed. Okay. Hence, I'm saying when you are dealing with React, you need to be careful. Okay. You need to know that variables are not automatically, they don't automatically update, more especially if they are not inside the use state. Okay, so let's see if we can improve that, or whatever that we're going to do will improve that. Okay, so what I'm going to do, I'm just going to say here const user ID. Okay, my apologies about that. Const user ID Set user ID. But still, when are we going to set the user ID? Okay. That will mean that we have to have some sort of a use effect. Okay. A use effect. But let's do it and see. Set user ID. Okay. Just to see if is it going to improve our code. Okay. Const user ID is equal to user ID. Use state. Okay. Let's see. Use state. The user ID is going to be what? Is it going to be a number or true or false? Let's just set it to a number. It's going to be a number or null. Let's type it here. It's going to be a number or null. Okay, my apologies about this. It can be a number or null. When it's starting, it's going to be null. I'm happy with this, which is this is false. And then let's use a use effect so that we can do something when the component loads for the first time. Okay. I think that's the other advantage of using things the React way. Okay. These might keep on executing every time the component re-renders. Okay. But here it will execute when the component renders for the first time. Okay, so let's just check and see how far that will take us. So it's important to think this way. Okay, don't take React casual and think you can do whatever you want. Okay, you might get into infinite loops and re-rendering. Okay, so let's see how far we can go with this. So when we are starting here, okay, we want to do what? We want to look for this data. Okay. Okay. So meaning that the, oh, my apologies about that. Okay. So we want this dependency, which is user data, to be here. What does this mean? This will be executed when this changes. Okay. As soon as the change has been detected here, this will be executed. So if there is a change here, what do we want to do? First of all, there is something that we want to check if it's true. Let's see here. We want to check first is, do we have this? Okay, do we have the active ID? Okay, do we have the active ID? Okay, before we do whatever that we want to do. If we have the active ID, it means that we can set the active ID into this ID because we have it. Okay. Okay. Because we have this ID, set user ID. Okay. Let me just change this to a capital letter, guys. Okay. All right. Okay. So once we have it, we are going to set it. So now the variable that we are going to use to detect, okay, it's this one, the user ID, which is going to be a number, and we can use it on the on our query, which is where here instead. Okay, so as you can see, when we are dealing with the query, we are not dealing with things that might be null, as you can see, guys. Okay, this is too much for the query. Okay, this might not be there, and then active, and as you can see, there is a lot of I'm not sure, some errors here, even though it was working before. Okay, let's just now use the user ID, which will come from the state. Okay, let's see. Based on what I'm thinking, I'm hoping this will be better than the one before, but we just have to test, guys. Okay, that's what you have to do when dealing with React. Okay, don't quickly assume that things are going to work and then continue with the code that is more like pure JavaScript. You might face some errors as time goes by, or your code is not going to be performant. Okay, so let's see, guys. Okay, so what we are doing now, we've got a state. I think this is the React-y way. Okay, we've got a state here. Okay, as soon as this state changes, okay, this will pick that up. Okay, we are assuming that this state will change to true. Okay, it will have something. That means it's going to be true And then we can execute this. Okay, when is this state going to change? When we set it here. Okay, when are we going to set it? When this user data changes. This user data will come as false, okay, will come as null, and then nothing will happen, or this will test, and then obviously if there is a null here on the user data, this is not going to execute. So as you can see, this will only execute on this is true, okay? And whenever this changes, we must first check, do we have the ID? Because we want to keep the query idling unless we've got the ID, okay? Let's see the difference in this approach, okay? Let's see the difference in this approach. Let's see. Okay, looks like it's waiting. Okay, let's see. User ID undefined is fetching false. API data false is fetching false. User ID is 1 is fetching false. And API data is false is fetching false. And then user ID is 1 is fetching false. Data is fetching false. And then user ID is 1 is fetching false, so that is false. And then user ID 1 is fetching, it's true. And then this starts to do that. Okay, cool. Now, what I want to do, okay, it looks like it's more or less like the same. And even I might say it looks like now there is a lot of retries here where this is 1. But this one is not changing. As you can see, 1, false, 1, false, 1, false, 1, false, okay? So let's just go back here and see, guys, okay? Before we continue, we are just testing, bulletproofing our code, okay? Let's see. Okay, let's see user data, question mark, dot active, okay, I see. Okay, so as soon as this data changes, this is going to alert. Oh, okay. Let me just go back here and see. Okay, so after this is 1, user ID is 1, there is fetching is true. Okay, after that. But I am concerned about these guys, okay, being false. Okay, I'm concerned about these guys being false. But for now, guys, let's continue. But for me personally, okay, as much as the first one looks like it was, I'm not sure, a little bit more efficient. But for me, in terms of React, I trust this one than the other one. Okay, this one to me looks like it's more bulletproof. Okay, we are checking this. Okay, is it null? If it's not null, if there is no ID, then we don't call this. Unless there is a user ID, we then test this. Okay. And then we will execute this once this has changed. Okay. I think so. This is null. Okay. So let's continue, guys. Okay. I trust the second version than the first one. Okay. Feel free to use whatever that might work for you. But it looks like we are able now to go to the API data and also to pass the ID. So let's go to our API endpoint. Where are we? I want to be on the API endpoint. What I want to do here now, step by step, first of all, I want to get this. Let's see what might go wrong here. We've got the task creator. Obviously, it's any, and we are awaiting request.json. And we are supposed to... I don't think we're supposed to get it. I don't think so. Usually, I do this when I am getting things from post, okay? Now, this is not being posted, okay? It's a query parameter, okay? Let me show you here. I hope I can find it somewhere where. Let me go to the network. The network is not going to show here. Let's go to, where is the network? Is it me? Here's the network, okay? So let's check here, guys. As you can see, this is a parameter, okay? It's not a post, okay? Task creator is equal to 1. It comes as a query parameter. There's a question mark. So there is a different way to handle it. Maybe this was causing the error, okay? Now, let's see what is the different way. Let's const, let's const the same task creator, okay? But we are going to change here. Okay, we want to get the request, okay? What's inside request? I think I can get parameters here, but I just have to think how to do that. The request has some parameters and path name, okay? Let's see, request dot get, is that correct? But we have parameters here, okay? Next URL, I think, because the URL has the parameters, but let's see. From here, do we have some base path? Yes. Everything that relates to path, host name, yes. Then, how can I get the params? I don't want this. Search params, okay? Search params. I think it has got a dot get. Yes, okay? As you can see, guys, okay? And then, we want to get the task creator, okay? My apologies about that. My mistake, okay? Does not exist on type string or null. Let's see. We are getting this. Let's see. Okay. Now, remember, before I was hoping that I'm going to receive this as an object. That's why I was destructuring. Okay. Here now, this is different. Okay. This is going to give me that string exactly. Okay. So what are we going to do? We're just going to return, instead of happy, let's return that one. Okay, that we are going to get here. Okay, let's see, guys. Okay, console log. In fact, even the network, I think the network can give us that. Where is it? Task creator. As you can see, guys, now we are getting one. Okay, and then what we need to do when we get this one, we need to test if is it we need to test is it true. We have something here or we have null. If it's true, if it's null, then return no user ID, which I don't think we are going to return no user ID because there is always an ID. Let's go back. Where is the query here? Let me just refresh. Okay, where is it? Okay, let's check here. Okay, task by ID. Here is it. As you can see, guys, we're getting success. I'm happy with this, okay? So let's continue, guys. And then what we want to do, before we return this, let's continue. Now, in this application, I've got a singleton, and at the moment, it has got the wrong spelling. I think on the next version of Met component, I will just change that spelling, okay? So let's say const, apologies about that. What are we doing? We are getting, okay, const, we are getting task totals, let's say task totals, okay, is equal to, I've got a singleton prisma here, okay, I'm not sure if it's, yeah, it's singleton, it starts with singleton, this method, but I don't know now why it's not here, singleton, okay. Const is equal to, I think it's singleton prisma. Let's see. Singleton prisma. Here is it. Okay. Obviously, as I've told you that I've noticed that the spelling, this is not singleton. This is more like sign. Okay. Singleton. Okay. I'm going to change it on the next version. Okay. This singleton prisma, I can dot. What do I want to do now? Let's see. This is equal to singleton prisma. Do I have to execute? I don't think so. Let's see. Dot tasks. Yes. Okay. So I don't have to execute it. My apologies about that. Dot tasks. Okay. So I think from now we can go back to ChatGPT and see what it was suggesting. Obviously, here they are getting their own prisma, their own way. Okay, but us, we also got the tasks there. We've got the group by, okay, group by status. where what we can do, let's just copy this as it is, and then we will modify it as we wish. In case maybe there are some variables which are not here, fields which are not here, then we can modify them. Let's click dot. Do we have group by here? Okay, we have it. Okay, cool. That means we are good to go. Let's just type here dot and paste. Okay, cool. I think we are winning, guys, okay? What can we say? We are selecting task. We are grouping task by status. Where task creator? Remember, as we have the task creator here. So let's put this task creator. And it looks like the task creator that we have from here is of type string. And that is true. We need to convert it to what? To a number. Let's pass int. This so that it can be a number. And now we don't have we don't have some issues. Okay, obviously before we continue, we need to put this in a try catch block, but for now we just want to test things. So I am going to remember, let's see, is this an async is it a promise? I think this is promise based. Okay, how do I know that? Let's check this. As you can see, this is a promise. We don't want that. So we need to await it. Okay, we want to await it because it's promise-based. And then we're going to get the actual data. Okay, and then what we want to do, we want to get this and return it on success. Okay, we want to see what are we going to get there. Okay. Now, let's go back here. Refresh. Okay, where is it? Okay, you just go down, 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 and then start from the bottom up, and then look for this. Here is it. It's still fetching. Okay. Let's see. It's returning back success. Okay, it looks like it has got what we want. Count all is one. Status, this is pending. Count all is one. Status completed. Count all is one. Status cancelled. Okay, I think this is true. Let's go back here and check. Is that the case? Yes. Okay, let's see. Pending, completed, and cancelled. It's 1111. Now, what we are going to do, we are going to change this completed to pending, let's say, so that we can have a pending of 2. Okay, let's go back here and let's refresh. My apologies about this. Let's refresh and see. Okay, where is it? That was quick. Here is it. As you can see, guys, now we've got the status is success. Yes. Pending, it's 2. And count, it's 1. Okay. Cancel, it's 1. And pending, it's 2. As you can see, guys, I think this is meaningful. Now, we need to take this data. Okay. Remember, we still... Let's just quickly do the error handling here. Okay. So that we cannot... get into a technical debt. Okay. We know that we have to fix this. So, let's just fix it. Okay. Try. Do this as soon as you catch an error. Okay, as soon as you catch an error, then what I want you to do, I want you to return an error message, okay, which is an error message. I hope this is an error message. Yes. Let's say query failed. Let's say Prisma query. Query failed. Okay, and then the status is 500. Why 500? It's because of it's the server that has failed while it was performing a task. I think there's a double thing here that we need to take out. Okay, and then we are trying here. Then if this has failed, display this. Okay, if this is true, I think you are supposed to return this here. Okay, you are supposed to return this here. So what you are going to return, now I don't want you to return success necessarily. Okay, I want you to return this data as it is and the status of 200. Okay, let's just double check, guys, before we continue. Is this still working? Okay, you never know. Where is the query? I don't see it. Here is it. Still loading. Okay, as you can see, guys. Okay, task totals. Here is the data, and I'm happy with the data. Okay, so what we want to do now, let's go to the front end. Where is our front end? Let's go to the front end. Where is my front end? Here is my front end, and here is my front end. So we can get this data by user. Okay, perfectly. Let's remove this. Okay. So what we are going to do, we need to display the stats card. Okay. Cool. We can't display the stats card if the data is being loaded. Okay, so which Boolean value can tell us here what's going on? I think this guy can tell us what's going on, which is this one. This guy has, let's come here. This guy has a dot here. Is pending, I think so. Is pending, as you can see. If it's pending, that means it's still busy processing. So if you are let's do it like this. Okay, let's see, guys. Let's see. I think this is the better way to do it. Okay, if you are pending, let's do it like this. If this guy is pending, okay, what can we do? I think I've got a better component that can solve this for me. Okay, check here, guys. On the met components, I've got a loading wrapper. Okay, okay, we are inside this. This is a center with gap. Okay, I've got a component here which I think it's is loading. Okay, is loading. Let's see. It's a component is loading. Okay, is loading. This component, what it does, it wraps whatever that you want to display. Okay, conditionally. Okay, it needs a Boolean value is loading, and then here we can pass the pending. Okay, this guy. Okay, get task total dot is pending. When is this guy pending? This guy is pending when it's still fetching the data. Okay, that means is pending. It's let's see. If is pending is true. Okay, if pending is true, is loading is going to be true, and then this guy will be loading in that meantime. Once we get the data, that means is pending is false, and this guy will stop loading. So what this guy does, this is loading. If this is true, it display a loading spinner, okay, or a progress something that shows progress if it's true. As soon as it's false, it will display the children. So let's see, guys, if that is the case. Okay, suppose, as you can see, guys, when it's loading, we don't see that until something change, and then once we get the data here, we will display it. Okay, I hope you do get this, guys. If you do, guys, please don't forget, I have got these courses. Please come and support me here. You will learn a lot of things, believe me, guys. Even if you don't have money, as long as you've got Udemy, you can come and click here. There is a lot of knowledge and content here for free, more especially this one. I think this one is almost like 70 to 80% of this is free, and also this one, it has got a lot of free things here. In case you might also want to support me, I have got a channel code, Coded UI. Okay, Coded UI, and here on Coded UI, I teach people how to do Figma. Okay, how to design awesome user interfaces using Figma. Okay, check here, guys. I've got some Figma. I'm a designer as well and a developer. Okay, I'm a developer and a designer as well. So check here, guys. Please come and support this channel. Please don't forget, guys. Let's keep these courses busy. Okay, because that's how I make a living, if I can be honest. Okay, so what else can we do, guys? I think we are winning here. Okay, our loading wrapper works well, as you can see. Now we need to display these accordingly. we need to have the finished task here, we need to have the pending task, the number of those tasks. And then how are we going to do that? I think, first of all, we are going to use one of these, not all of them, okay? One of these. And then, what do I want to do? Now, it looks like this guy is wrapping over these. Let's check. As you can see, guys, now this center and gap row, and they are not applying, okay, because they are not in here. So I am thinking that this guy, okay, this guy, the loading wrapper, it must wrap this guy with this. Okay, I think so. Okay, let's remove it here. Okay, check here, because we want this style, the centering and the gap. Okay, so this guy must be here. So meaning that now the look will still be the same. Okay, let's check the loading. Okay, let's see, is loading. As you can see, guys, it will load, okay, accordingly, and then from there it will display. Okay, cool, I'm happy with that. And then now let's come in here. Okay, obviously here we are only going to use one, okay, but we're going to loop through it. Okay, so now let's do this. Let's get into here, and we are going to get, what is that function, that mutation function, get tasks. Okay, I think there is a better way to do this. I keep on forgetting these names. Okay, and in the previous tutorial I came with a system where I must have a form query or a form mutation so that I don't have to memorize this name. So this one, it's not a form necessarily because there's no form here. So let's just name it query. Okay. Okay. The reason why I'm doing that, I don't want to be caught up into get task and get what. Let me just call it query. Okay. Query.dispending. So as you can see, so going forward, I won't struggle. I want query. Not query object, I want query only. Let's see, query dot data. Okay, what is the shape of this data? Let's come here. Okay, let's come here and let's check what is the shape of this data so that we can use it. All right, are we still rolling? Yes. Okay, what is the shape of this data? Let's go to success. And where is it? Nothing. Where is it? Loading, loading, loading. Yes, because where is the loading one? Here is it. Okay, let's see. If we can loop through it, it's an array. Okay. I think it has got dash count. I believe there is a way to make this meaningful. Okay, I believe. And then on count, it has got what can I say? It has got all, which is two, and then status is equal to pending. First of all, let me loop through all of these, and then I'm going to display the status. Okay, I'm going to display the status. I think so. Okay, we've got this, and then loop through it. Let's do that first. Okay, so what I want to do, I have got the data and I want to dot map, but this guy doesn't allow me to map. The reason is, in terms of typing, it's not aware if the returned data, it has got an array. Okay, cool, let's just create a fake let's just create a fake type so that we can get the map. Okay, only get the map. Okay, we will fix the type as we go along. So where can we pass, where is the query? Here is the query. Who can we tell that the return data is of an array type? I think this query, it's a generic function. Okay, you can pass the type here, even this one. Okay, Okay, even this one is the one that I created from my library met component. I think also, let's see, as you can see, you can tell it. So let's just tell this one, and this one will get it from here. Okay, so let's say it's an array of what? Let's say inside there is it tasks? Okay, let's only put this one status. Okay, let's put is it status or statuses? Status. Okay, so we've got status in here. My apologies about that. We've got status here, and the status for now, I'm going to say it's a string, and that is not correct. Okay, the status, it's of the enum. Okay, it's either a spending, it's some sort of a list of specific values. But for now, we are testing, guys. Let's just leave status. This is not only just an object, but it's an array. Let's see. I apologize about that. Does this guy now, is it aware of this status and thing? It looks like it's aware, guys. Okay, as you can see. Let's go back here on data. Are you aware now of this mapping? Can we map now? It looks like we can map now because it knows that we are returning an array. And then when mapping, we want to return. Okay, we want to return this as it is. Okay, let's put this as it is. And what might be, oh, okay. When you are mapping through JSX element, you always need to put a key here. Okay. Okay, that was the issue. And then for now, let's receive the item, okay, and index. Index is just a unique number, 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. This key must always be unique, so it can be 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, okay? So, what do I want next? I think now I am supposed to display these cards, okay, these component 3 times, okay? Let's go back here and test. We're supposed to display these 3 times, okay? Obviously, it's going to be the same thing, but we are supposed to display them 3 times, okay? So, what I want to do, what I want to do here, I want to display these 3 times. Let's see what is going on. Query.data, .map, item.index. What is the problem? Let's see. Let's see. Type error. Query that has map. It's not a function. Let's see. A lot of times when something's not a function, it's when you have not used this. Okay, cool. Not a problem. Maybe what we need to do, query.data.map. Maybe what I need to do, did I manage to check if is this true? Okay, let's see, when do I display this first? Okay, I can only display it when this is not pending. Okay, cool. So what we can do first, let's comment this, okay? Let's comment this. Let's comment this, let's say. Okay. Let's try to see if can we display without looping. Let's say in a paragraph tag, something inside this, okay? Query dot data. Okay, let's see. Is there a variable? Let's see, let's see, let's see. Query dot data. Where do I want to be? Okay. For now, let me just type anything here. Okay, for now. Let's see, why are you red? Let's see. Why are you red? Maybe. Okay, now I'm a bit confused, but okay, as you can see, guys, now we are winning, okay? So what I want to do, I want to check in this object, okay? The one that we are getting. Are we getting straight to the arrays, or maybe they are under a certain name, which is tasks, let's say, or something. Okay, that is important for us to know. Let's see, network. Network. Looks like now I don't see this. Let's see, where is it? Here is it. And then let's just double check this. Okay. It looks like to me we've got tasks tutorials here, which is an array, not an array straight. Okay. Looks like to me. So let's go to our fake. Where is it? Here is it. Okay. This fake type. We want task tutorials first. And then task tutorials, it's going to be okay, obviously I don't, what do I want to do? What do I want to do? Undo. Maybe we can start from here. All right. Okay. I think let's see. What do I want to do? Let me delete everything because I'm confused. This is going to be a task tutorials, the one that I'm going to get first. Okay, let me type that. That is going to be an object that has got status of string. We are going to change it later to be an enum. Status of string. And then we are going to, I think this is what I'm looking for. So when you get in here in this task totals, you are going to get an array. So when we are here, we want to get into query, which is this query.data, but dot task totals. I think we are winning. And I want at zero, and then I want to bang the status. So we are supposed to display here the first pending. Okay, as you can see, guys, we are winning. That's what we want. And then from then, let's go back to our looping. Okay, obviously it might have some errors because there is a bracket that I deleted, which was a closing bracket. Okay, let's just comment this one and see. Okay, obviously here we can map on data because we need task totals. Okay, and then we can map on that. Okay, so let's see if we're going to display three of these. Okay, because of we've got three of these, let's check. Obviously, guys, my apologies, it's two of these because the first two, it's the same thing, it's pending, so it's going to have a total of two. Okay, so now let's give it some meaningful name. So in this item, okay, let's see, in this item we've got, let's check here, we don't want the key, we want the title. The title, it's a number. I think we're going to put this on a description. Okay, let's do that on the description. We can put this item dot status. Okay, now this is supposed to be more meaningful. Okay, pending, it's 24, cancelled, it's 24. Okay, obviously our types, which is the number, it's wrong. So our types don't include, our types for now, check here, they don't include the dash count and. Okay, and also I believe there is a better way to do that, maybe to alias those count. Okay, because now there's a lot of dash underscore, in fact not dash, there's a lot of underscore, but for now, to make things simple, we are going to deal with the underscores. Okay, so our typing is correct here. Okay, but inside the array it says we only have status, of which that's not true. Inside this inside that object we've also got underscore count that has got all. Okay, so let's take things one by one. Let's create an object here in this type. Where is it? Where is that type? Here is it. Okay, so there will be a status, as you can see. Let's see. The status is inside here. Okay, yes. And the count also is inside there. So Let's go back here, say underscore count, and then my apologies about this. This is not right. Undo. Okay, I need to delete this string thing. Okay, so we've got this object, but inside this object, it looks like it has got also underscore all. That's where we get this number. Okay, and then as I think, is this a number or a string? Let's see. I think it's a number. So let's. So now our type, it's more realistic. Okay, it's more realistic. It's supposed to give us what we want. So what we can do now, we can go to the number, which is the title. Okay, here in the title, we are going to get items dot count dot all. Okay, obviously this is expecting a string, not a problem. Let's convert this to string. Let's see what we want to do. Dot, let's see, dot to string. That's what I want to do, guys. Okay, and I think we are almost finishing, guys. Okay, if you've made it this far, I'm proud of you. That is it, guys. We've got a proper working dashboard. Okay, so let's test our dashboard. Let's say we want to add a new to-do. Okay, let's say another pending. Okay, another pending. Okay, let's just put a date, and then let's put an image there. Added another pending. Okay, let's click register. Okay, that means we've created a new to-do, and let's go back to the dashboard and see. Now, guys, our stats has updated. We've got 3 pending. Okay, so if we can go here and maybe as you can see now, we've got pending and cancel. What if maybe we can have another one, which is, let's say completed. Okay, let's say we've got completed. Now let's see, is this going to increase? As you can see, guys, okay, the other thing which is very important, why when I'm coming back here, this refreshes? Do you think I did that? No, it was not me. Who did it? It's 10 stack query. So maybe if you were struggling with what I was doing here with this, where is our query with this, maybe you were like, this is unnecessary, I can just use a fetch. There's a lot of important things or awesome method that 10 stack query will help us with. As you can see, guys, I don't have to refresh, because every time when I hit this or when I'm coming back from here, it will refresh and it will update. So as you can see, guys, so let's just try it for the last time. What if maybe we've got where is 2 completed? Let's change this completed to another one, let's say, which is in progress for some reason. Okay, check here, guys, where is our code? Okay, we've got a pending, we've got 1 in progress, we've got a 1 completed. Is it only 3 of them? Pending, we've got 2 pending. Okay, let's change another pending to cancelled. Okay, because we didn't have a cancel before. I'm expecting to see 4 of these. Okay, the ones that are pending, it's 1 in progress, 1 completed, 1 and cancelled, 1. Okay, guys, in the next video we are going to change these colors accordingly. Okay, maybe cancelled, they are going to be green, and. I am Matthew Msingati. I'm a designer and at the same time I'm a developer. If you feel like this video has added value to you, please do me a favor. Please come here on Coded UI and learn some skills on creating Figma components. And also, guys, please don't forget, I rely on you. I've got these 2 awesome courses. Okay, please come and support me here. See you on the next one.